الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين Praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and He's the only one worthy of praise. I seek His help, His guidance, and His forgiveness. I believe in Him and I trust Him. I seek refuge on Almighty Allah from the evil of our passions. Indeed, whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides him to Al-Islam, no one can mislead him after Allah. And whomsoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him astray, no one can guide him after Allah. I testify openly that there is no deity worthy of worship except Allah Rabbil Alameen. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his messenger and the seal of all the prophets. O Muslims, you must know that the best speech is the speech of Almighty Allah, which is the Quran. The best guidance is the course of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which is his sunnah. The worst of all affairs is innovation and addition to the religion of Islam. Indeed, every addition to the religion of Islam will lead to hellfire. I adjure you as well as myself to fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the best of your ability. Fear Allah and don't die unless you are in a state of Islam. In actuality, my khutbah today, I had prepared it in Arabic. And this was a response to a question by somebody from the Muslims who attend the mosque here. He's a professor, and he asked me a question, and something supposed to be like ABC of Islam. And since I could not see the brother here, he may upstairs, but it's so amazing that things can be from the ABC of Islam, but a majority of people are not paying attention to it. I remember in 1985, I went to give a lecture in USC, and a professor, Arab, that means his language, his mother tongue is Arabic, and he's a professor, he used to teach sometimes. And he used to come here also to USC. And he stood up after the lecture, contradicting what I'm saying, and says the hijab is nothing from Islam. It has nothing to do with Islam or Quran. This is a Turkish culture been introduced to Islam. Say subhanAllah. We have two surahs, at least in the Quran, clear cut, talks about hijab of woman. How a person born in Arabia, his mother tongue is Arabic, professor, and a person that with all this big status among the people, he does not know even that hijab exists in the Quran, is so amazing. And this, now I'm going to have to shift to try to tell you something about the basic of Islam. If you don't know who you are, you have missed the target. You have missed the goal. You never can reach to the purpose that you've been created for. Do you know who you are? You are Abdullah. If you think you are something other than this, you miss it already. You are Abdullah. And the sister is Amatullah, slave, servant of Allah. Doesn't matter where you're born, what kind of education, what kind of degree you got. If you miss this point, so you here could not fulfill your mission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us clear cut in the Quran. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ ما أريد منهم من رزق وما أريد أن يطعمون إن الله هو الرزاق ذو القوة المتين. Allah is saying, I did not create jinn or mankind except for one main goal. What it is to debase yourself, is to serve, to be a servant of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, if you don't know this, you're going to think that you are here to be serving other things. Because if you did not serve Allah, if you did not enslave yourself to Allah, believe it or not, you're going to be a slave of something else or somebody else. You'll be a slave of something or someone other than Allah. And slavery is bad when it's to anything or anyone other than Allah. And slavery, I don't mean serve, slavery. I know the difference between two words, okay? I know my English is not that good, but I know there is a difference between being a slave and to be a servant. And when you see the person who comes, when you go to the restaurant and serve you, you tip him. If he don't like the work, he will say bye and he leaves. But when you are a slave, you don't have the choice what kind of work, what kind of words, what kind of time that you're going to do. It's two different things. We are not serving Allah. Because when you're serving, that somebody needs your assistance also. And that you have the choice to be there or not. But being a slave, you're like a captive. That you have no choice of your matter of your affairs. And by the way, you have to understand, slavery is very bad if it's been done to anything or to anyone other than Allah. But when you became the slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is an honor for you. Because you know who you are, being the slave of Allah, not something else or somebody else. So this has become an honor for you. If you can accomplish being a slave and abdullah and amatullah in this life, now your place will be Jannah. Now Allah will be pleased with you. Now you have fulfilled the mission that you've been created for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى. Allah is the one cause you to laugh or to cry. And He has the ability and the means, and He is the one that make means for you to laugh and make means for you to cry. And He is the one give you life and cause you to die. So can now to know about who is your master. Your master is the one who gives you life and takes this life from you. Your master is the one can make you speak or you be wild. That you can laugh or you can cry. And by the way, this is slavery is a general. So that you can be willingly or unwillingly. So everything under the sky, even the sky itself, is a slave of Allah. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى إِلَى السَّمَاءِ فَقَضَاهُنَّ سَبْعَ سَمَاوَاتٍ. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rose to the heaven, and Allah said to the sky and the earth, اِتِيَا طَوْعًا أَوْ كَرْهَا قَالَتَا أَتَيْنَا طَائِعِينَ. Allah said for the land, for the earth to be formulated and the sky, come willingly or unwillingly. So they understand, they hear, they willing, and they say, oh Allah, we come willingly. So everybody, Muslim or non-Muslim, is a slave of Allah. How? Even if he doesn't pray. Because you could not control how many heartbeats comes in the second or in a day. You could not control to breathe or not to breathe. You could not control yourself what color that you're going to have when you're born or what age when you die. So everybody, jinn, angel, everything are a slave that been forced again is their own will about certain things. They have no choice about it. You tell me that you're going to die when you are 42 years and 3 days and 5 hours and 2 seconds. You tell me this and guarantee so I can know that you are a free man. You have your own choice. Even the sun, even the moon, everything. That they have no choice, and by this they are slaves of Allah. They carry the purpose that Allah created them for. But to any slave yourself with your only choice, now you became from ibadullah. So you have the choice. And you're going to be rewarded according to your choice. But if you refuse to worship Allah, you still can eat, you can drink, you can go and come. But after this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be dealing with you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed all mankind, not only the Muslim. And He said what? Ya ayyuhan nas. He didn't say, oh, who you believe. He said, oh mankind, ya ayyuhan nas, u'budu rabbakum alladhi khalaqakum, walladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Oh mankind, enslave yourself to your Lord. What's your Lord? الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ, the one who created you. So anyone who didn't create you, he has no rights to be your master or to tell you how to live or how to do anything. So Allah said, worship him, obey him, listen to him, follow his order, because what? الَّذِي خَلَقَكُمْ, because he's the one created you. Not only you. وَالَّذِينَ مِنْ قَبْلِكُمْ. And why is this slavery? لَعَلَّكُمْ تَتَّقُونَ, that you may avoid his wrath, his anger, his punishment, because he's غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ, most forgiving, most merciful, and شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. So when you enslave yourself to Allah, you will have the taqwa and the protection from hellfire. You will get the reward. So Allah called in everybody to enslave themselves, because when somebody puts a gun in your head and tell you be a Muslim means to surrender willingly your will to the will of Allah. And Islam means a total submission. Some people say Islam means peace. Islam, the word Islam means to surrender willingly to the will of Allah. Islam means total submission to the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By doing what he said, do, and they stay away from what he said, stay away from it. This is what means submission. There is a train track, and when the train try to get out of the track, now you know what's going to happen. So Allah say, stay on the track. Obey what I'm saying. And for you to have this ubudiyyah, to be slave of Allah, that means love, total fear, total hope. Mahabba, khawf, and raja. Three principles. This is the ubudiyyah. That love and fear and hope. One is missing, you could not be the slave servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا يَعْبُدُونَ. In every day in our prayer, we memorize this, what you call, rehearse this. It's something that you have to do it every day.
Routine.
I don't want to use the word routine actually, but the word could not come to my mind now. But in every day, you repeat this again and again and again in a minimum of 17 times a day. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين. إياك نعبد إياك. And he did not say نعبد إياك, because if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put the verb before the pronoun, that means we worship you Allah, we obey you Allah, and we love you Allah, we fear you Allah, and the president and the king and the system. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala know what he's saying, so he put the pronoun before the verb. He said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. Thee alone and only, this what it is when you bring in this before that. So he said, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ. You repeat this every day. How you can repeat it every day, a minimum of 17 times, and you did not know why you are here in this life. And if you did not understand this, this is the reason you're making a choice different from Allah's choice. How your master telling you, get the car ready and you're going to cook a lunch for him. Master, I'm serving you, I'm making lunch. I didn't ask lunch. I asked to wash the car. So a Muslim doesn't understand a basic thing of إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ, which he repeated 17 times minimum every day, and only saying إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ, thee alone and only that we worship, that we debase ourselves. إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ.
A Muslim did not understand a lesson to be repeated every day. You are 50 years old, 60 years old, and you don't know what does it mean, what you're repeating it every day 17 times. Why? What's wrong? You don't know Arabic? You can read it in English. You can read it in Urdu. You can read it in Chinese. Translation is available everywhere. That means Allah say, be my abd, be my slave, listen to me, obey me, love me, fear me, hope me. 17 times. And after this we don't know, and somebody said, I don't like this word. We are not abid, we are not ibad. We are creation of Allah. What do you mean, creation of Allah? The roach, the water bug is a creation of Allah. The fly is a creation of Allah. So what? Are you a fly? You are the one that Allah is saying, وَلَكَدْ كَرَّمْنَا بَنِي آدَمَ. Allah said, indeed we have honored the sons and the generation of Adam. Why? Because he gave mind to understand, to think, to reflect, to understand, to follow, to make rules. So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you, He created everything. Allah created the rock, Allah created the mountain. And Allah telling us, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. So what is the difference between me and the mountain? That I look to the mountain like nothing. Is nothing but a mountain. It's a rock. But Allah said, if I reveal the Quran on a mountain, you will see the mountain humbling himself out of the fear of Allah. Do we interact or reflect or feel different when we recite the Quran? Now you understand that everything in the creation of Allah is worshipping Allah, is obeying Allah. Did he ever go to milk the cow and the cow told you no? Did he ever try to ride the horse and the horse said, no, you could not ride me? Because Allah has subjected him for your own use, so everything carries your orders and their obligation. And everything showing servitude to Allah except to mankind and jinn. ولكن أكثر الناس لا يعلمون. Most of the people they don't know. وقليل من عبادي الشكور. Only few among my slave servants that grateful to me. So the only ones that been given the understanding and the logic to do, they use their logic not to serve Allah in totality, but portion. As example, maybe in Jum'ah. Maybe you understand when we get married, let's see which mosque, is there a mosque here so we can marry according to Islam. What about your economic? What about your social life? What do you think is ibadah is only salah? You think you be a slave of Allah only when you go to the mosque and you do like this, and when it comes about income, oh, this is my life. No, so we did not understand what does it mean to be a slave. That because you think you are a partial slave, that you're part-time a slave, you don't know that you 24/7 supposed to be trying your best to be the slave servant of Allah. Why? Because Islam is saying, قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ لَا شَرِيكَ لَهُ وَبِذَلِكَ أُمِرْتُ وَأَنَا مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَأَنَا أَوَّلُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Say, my prayer, my sacrifice, my prayer, my sacrifice. This it? No, brother. Sunday? Okay. Christian. Saturday? Jewish. Muslim? Oh, we have Friday. Doesn't work like this here. This because you don't understand what is Islam? You don't understand what does it mean to be Abdullah, slave servant of Allah. In Islam, say, my prayer, my sacrifice, my daily life. My daily life when you get up until you go to sleep. And even how you go to sleep, it has to be the plan of your master, Almighty Allah. وصلاتي ونسكي ومحياي ومماتي لله رب العالمين. That your life, your death, your social life, your economic life, your political life have to be according to your master. Otherwise, you are refusing. Or that you did not understand what is ubudiyya in Islam, to be Abdullah and Amatullah. Wallahi, brothers, subject is so great, so big, misunderstood by a lot of Muslims. And I feel sorry that we always have to be watching the clock. Why? Because we have love for other things more than Allah. If you did not know your first homework, how are you going to be successful in any other work? You study all these books, you get all these degrees and basic words in Islam. Wallahi, I see some people with degrees, I don't even have it, they don't know how to perform the proper prayer. That because what? Because we give slavery to others than Allah. We put something to be more important in our lives than Allah and the deen of Allah. And the deen of Allah became for occasions. When somebody died, when somebody get married, when somebody have aqiqah, when somebody this and that, this is the only time we, most of the Muslim will be asking about. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave a special title to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, He gave him the highest degree. It was not a master degree, it was not a PhD degree, it was not a professor degree. He gave him what? Abd. Abd, Allah called him Abd. In the highest and the best place. When you want to introduce somebody in a big official people and big shots, you say this so and so and so and so and he this, he do this. When Allah introduced his prophet and praised him, he said, Subhanalladhi asra bi'abdihi laylan. Glory be to Allah who took his slave, Muhammad, by journey at night. In the Quran, which is supposed to be a witness to the prophet, calling the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to be abd, to be a slave. So if the prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a slave, who you are to deny to be a slave of Allah or to try to hide? No, Islam doesn't talk about being a slave. We only creation of Allah. If you are creation of Allah, so the fly is a creation of Allah, so why you going to put yourself equal to a fly or a water bath? You are a person whom Allah made you to take the taklif. Take the obligation to know what is halal, what is haram. Listen to this. لن يستنكف المسيح عيسى بن مريم لن يستنكف المسيح أن يكون عبدا لله ولا الملائكة المقربون ومن يستنكف عن عبادته ويستكبر فسيحشرهم إليه جميعا. Say, Jesus, peace be upon him, the Messiah, never can reject to be a slave of Allah. Isa, son of Mary, the slave servant of Allah, never can reject to be the slave of Almighty Allah, neither the angels who are near to Allah. It's an honor for us. And it would be good that when we die, that we have fulfilled this mission. My brothers and sisters, try to understand what's your mission. Try to understand why you've been created. Try to get the honor and enslave yourself to Allah. That obey Him and Him alone. And do not put any other saying over the saying of Allah. Don't put any other ideology or understanding more than what Allah had revealed, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, like I said, the subject is so big, but I have to finish. So I beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the correct understanding about our deen. Ameen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, wa salatu wa salam ala Rasulil Kareem. We say that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had stated, Ta'isa abdul dirham, Ta'isa abdul dinar, Ta'isa abdul dirham, Ta'isa abdul khamisa, تعس عبد الخميمة إن أعطي راضية وإن لم يعط سخط تعس وانتكث وانتكث وإذا شيك فلن تقش. زرد عبودية أثر ذن الله. Allah has said, if you want to free yourself from Allah, not to be Abdullah, you're going to be a slave to somebody else or something else. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, misfortune the slave of the dollar. Misfortune, loser, the slave of the suit. Misfortune the slave of the degree, the car, whatever it is that became like an ilah and deity that you give all your love and even you fight for it. You stand for it with all your forces. Brothers and sisters, you have to understand the gods nowadays not made out of, the idols is not made out of rocks like used to be in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But believe it or not, we have many gods and we have many idols in our life. And we need really to renew our shahada, to understand what does it mean, La ilaha illallah. That you could not love anyone beyond Allah. You could not adhere to anyone more than Allah. You could not fear anyone more than Allah. And this what is the reality of La ilaha illallah. And some of these gods that we see nowadays, logic. Okay? Some people when they don't think fit with their logic, say, brother, it doesn't make sense. Those people that Allah saying, أَفَرَأَيْتَ مَنِ اتَّخَذَ إِلَهَ هُوَهُوَهُ وَأَضَى اللَّهُ اللَّهُ عَلَى عِلْمٍ. Do you see the one who takes his logic as a god beside Allah? And Allah had misled all those that he had the information. Logic, and especially the people, they feel they're so educated. Now they feel I'm so educated. And what you're saying here in Islam, it doesn't make sense to me. Yeah, I know it's in Quran, but there is no, this hadith in Bukhari, but it's not in the Quran. Because we put all our eggs in one basket. From you 6 years old, until you became almost 42 or 35, you are studying, but you are not related to Islam. Basically, you inherit something your father, grandfather used to do, but you don't know Islam in depth. At least the basic of Islam. As a result of this, anything doesn't make sense to you, you reject it. And feel because I have a PhD, and I'm going to Harvard University, and I'm this and that, that I have the right now to say something about Islam and the deen of Allah. As respect to all of you, and advice to all of you, regardless whatever your degree, you need to start to study and learn your deen. Because your logic, it can take you to hellfire. And I mean it. And I make it with sincere and concern and love. Your logic can take you to hellfire. And Allah says that this is a form of shirk. Some people, they worship in the shaitan. Whatever the shaitan tells them. And as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us, إِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ يَقُونَ إِلَىٰ أُولِيَائِهِمْ لِيُجَادِلُوكُمْ. Indeed, the shaitan give revelation, give thoughts, give the idea, give you way how to debate, okay? And also from that gods that became in people life, so they are not a slave to Allah, is Kurat al-Qadam, okay? To such a degree, football, not the football of America, okay? But we have different kind of ball, many balls, and people became so much deep in love, and the people, they spend their life to train themselves, and so they're going to be heroes. So they love for it, and even they fight for it, and even they kill each other, even if they're Muslims. And it happened. It happened. Okay? They kill each other for it. They're spending, they're studying, they're training, everything because of ball. Be running behind a ball. Some people, they're God, and they became a slave of the fashion. And they allow people to manipulate and work and play in their system, in their mind. And in every time there is a special clothes, a special dress. Can you see a woman that have, a dress supposed to be for a wedding and she will go attend for a death or a funeral with the same one? No, they made a dress for funerals. And a dress code and a dress, you understand, color for wedding.
and a dress for night and parties, and a dress for this and that, and for the summer. And you find the people what? In love and running behind the fashion. If they have a zipper to the side, now we can throw this pants and get one with the zipper to the side. Why? Because the dictation, the one who giving you, the one who guiding you, the one who's telling you is the fashion, which run by few people. They take in your money, they make you become a slave for them. Whatever fashion they give you, you will go about it. Doesn't matter if you are a man or a woman, a girl or a young or old, whatever. Fashion became another god in the people's life. Dollar. This was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Da'is abdul dirham." That people spend so much, so much. Why the mosque is empty the whole week? Get so crowded, and some people want to understand to enlarge the mosque, because this became something like occasion. We go. 100 people, 500 people, 1,000 people in the mosque in Jum'ah. And after this, bye-bye Jum'ah, see you next week. Why? Because the dollar. Because the life, because the building, because what the museum, because what you build in your life. You be sitting, wallahi, I see people leave the Jum'ah, step outside answering the phone. I swear by Allah. Why? Because it's so important to them. It's so important, they could not be... devote 45 minutes for Jum'ah and sit still, no talking, coming closer, sit down with adab, discipline. We know the discipline, the code. Every place we go, we know it. When it comes about mosque, we don't know it. People step outside and showing their respect. I'm not going to answer, talking the phone, who was the imam, gives the khutbah, say step outside. What are you doing? What are you doing? So became a slave of the dollar. Slave of the fashion. Whatever the fashion, we will do it. Doesn't matter if it please Allah or not, I'm going to wear it. I'm going to be proud. I'm going to be doing it because he became a slave of something else. One of the things, the parties, and this nowadays, gods, okay? This is social party, and this is the what you call democracy party, and this, and people became fighting, spending their money, bringing their time and everything, because this became another god in their life. And you know that how the people for your understanding with Soviet Union, about they tried to establish communism there, they killed about 20 million Muslims in the Soviet Union. Why? Because they want to impose this on the people. The people have to believe in this system. So the system, from democracy, sociality, name all this ism, became another god in people's life, and people love this, fear it, people have to submit to it, and hoping that this is what's going to change, this is what is going to make life better, this is what's going to make the economic better. Is nothing except a mirage. يحسبه الظمآن ماء حتى إذا جاءه لم يجده شيئا. It's nothing but a mirage, brothers. Wake up, worship Allah alone, and enslave yourself to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فقلت استغفروا ربكم إنه كان غفارا يرسل السماء عليكم مدرارا ويمددكم بأموال وبنين ويجعل لكم جنات ويجعل لكم أنهارا ما لكم لا ترجون لله وقارا. I said to them, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seek Allah His forgiveness. Come back to the law of Allah. Come back to the Sharia, come back to the Deen, come back to the Sunnah, come back to the Mosque. I said to them, seek forgiveness of Allah. Indeed, He's the most forgiving, and He will shower you with rain. He will give you gardens, He will give you children, He will give you this and that. The economics, all the social life, everything is damaged. There is no any way. And now, we're scaring the people from Islam and Sharia, because if you do this, you're going to lose it. Those people about nothing except killing and shooting and hijacking and all these things. No, because somebody is benefit from you to be a slave to their system, so they don't want you to see the light at any time. Brothers and sisters, if you want to be saved, if you want to be a winner, if you want to be successful in this life, in your grave and in the hereafter, come back to Allah, make Allah to be your master, make the deen to be your direction, and this is the only way for success.
This is the only way for civilization. We are proud to be slave servant of Allah. إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله هيا على الصلاة هيا على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
Stand walking from straight the line, please. Stop. Of your right, your left, make sure the line is straight, shoulder to shoulder, foot to foot. Straighten the line by the heel, not to the toes. Keep the line straight while you pray. Stavu, irtadilu. الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين آمين قل هو الله أحد الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله
أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
Assalamu alaikum. Just one quick announcement. April 20th, which is 15 days from now, we're planning on having a Share Islam Day at the Masjid. So if you could please get some invitation cards and hand them out to any non-Muslims you interact with, we need people to do that. And there's also a meeting tonight after Salat al-Maghrib for anyone who would like to volunteer for Share Islam Day. We need people to help serve food, and we especially need male hosts for tables. So if anyone would like to participate, the attendance at the meetings has been low, so we need more participation from the community. Jazakallah khair. Assalamu alaikum.
I'd like to remind you that tomorrow, inshallah, social gathering, everybody's invited. Tomorrow is a social gathering. Bring your family and come eat dinner with us, inshallah. 6 o'clock p.m. Jazakum khair.